So many people, when they actually travel from the US to Europe and they consume wheat products, they have no bloating. They don't have near the digestive problems. They don't even necessarily gain weight. Now, I am definitely not recommending consuming wheat, but I want to talk about the difference between wheat from America versus wheat from Europe. So there's a huge difference. When people are consuming breads and pastas and cereals and crackers and biscuits in the United States, they get acne, they get bloating, they get a lot of inflammation in their gut. They also have lethargy, they're tired, but you don't really see as much of that in Europe, at least from the wheat. Why is that? What is the differences? Well, in America, 60% of the wheat is red wheat. Now, what is red wheat? Compared to certain countries in Europe, they use white wheat. So red wheat is soft, it's fluffy, it has a longer shelf life, it has a lot more carbohydrate, and it has much more protein, specifically gluten. The wheat that they use in Europe has much less gluten. That's the protein in wheat that causes a lot of the problems in the gut. But that's not the only difference. In America, the wheat is not necessarily genetically modified, but they use glyphosate in a lot of the wheat, which is the chemical they normally spray on genetically modified crops. Now, they say glyphosate is not harmful to humans. It's only harmful to bacteria. But the problem is humans have a lot of bacteria growing inside and outside their bodies. In fact, humans are dependent on their microorganisms. So glyphosate directly attacks this microbiome and disturbs the flora and the ability for someone to digest. Now, GMO foods in general and glyphosate is banned in many European countries. Now, there's one more point I want to bring up, and it has to do with iron, fortification. So in grain products that are refined, they tend to fortify it with synthetic vitamins and iron. And of course, the source of iron that they're using to fortify is actually not the type that your body can easily break down. This type of iron that's fortified in wheat in America kind of sits in your gut. It tends to generate more pathogenic bacteria. And then if we compare this to European countries like France, Denmark, and Sweden and other countries, they use no fortification at all. So I just wanted to do this video to talk about the difference from the America versus European wheat. Of course, I'm not recommending consuming wheat. I'm just talking about the difference. So if you're enjoying my content, which I hope you are, and you're applying this knowledge to your health, and you have a success, I'd really appreciate you sharing your success story. So click the link down below to my website where you can upload your success story so you can help inspire others.